Our first song on Thursday, November 27th, was Monster by Eminem featuring Rihanna. Hello, everyone. I'm James from Royal Pirates, and it's been 3 days since I started filling in for Aaron here on Music Access. And are you guys getting a little used to my voice by now? Because I'm just getting used to it, because I think in the beginning I was trying to have a radio DJ voice or something, so I ended up sounding like a robot, but now I can just talk to you comfortably and I feel like we know each other. Well, I hope you guys are enjoying it, and I'm getting a bit more comfortable. We're gonna spend the next 2 hours having fun with you guys here on Music Access. So here's a look at what we have up today. Okay, the first hour will be pretty much the same as yesterday with Who Am I Part 2 and AA Music Quiz. But in the second hour, we'll discuss your problems and worries with Good Looking and the very nice Kihoon on Why So Serious. And here's this week's topic for Dancing in the Club MA. So I heard this corner is all about letting loose and having fun. This week's topic is the things that drive me crazy and the songs that drive me crazy. What drives you crazy? Your parents nagging, or your dog that barks at you, the guy that you suddenly have a crush on, or the girl you have a crush on, a gripping sports match. What are some songs that you can't stop listening to? Let us know the reason why, but just write Club MA on your title when you send in your messages. And here's another important announcement. Here's how you can listen to Music Access with James of Royal Pirates and how you can participate. You can download the Arirang Radio or TuneIn Radio app on your smartphones, and you can also send us messages through the app using the comment function. You can also listen to us by visiting our website, www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess, and leave your messages there on our message board. You can also see our broadcast in real time. And another way you can tune in is through terrestrial DMB, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo, and 101.9 for Taejeong. So we talked about a lot of different ways that you can tune in to us. And if there's a song that you'd like to hear during the program, you can send in your song request as well. Just remember to write request on your title and tell us a little bit about why you want to hear the song. I'll try hard to introduce as many messages for you guys as I can during the show. And for more information about the corners that we'll be doing this week, it's available on our message board, so make sure you take a look, and I look forward to hearing from you guys real soon. We're going to go back and listen to a song before we come back to some of your messages, talking about my first day here on Music Access with Message Time, okay? So in the meantime, let's listen to this song first. Up next, we've got Pitbull with Celebrate. Alright, the song you just heard was Celebrate by Pitbull. I'm Royal Pirates James, filling in for Aaron of New East as he's away on tour, and you're listening to Music Access. Well, it's now time to find out what our Music Access family members are doing and where they are with Message Time. Alright, Julianne Lee from USA says, Hi James, I just wanted to thank you for reading my message yesterday, and I freaked out when I heard it, and it was completely unexpected for me. I'm in the middle of college applications right now, and I was hoping you could help me out a little bit by giving me a shout out again, and it would mean a lot to me. Regardless of whether you read this out loud, just know that I'm grateful for you taking your time to read all these messages. Keep working hard, and I hope to see you back in LA in the near future. I'll buy you, Moon, and Suyun some of your beloved In-N-Out. Wow, Julianne. Well, I can't believe you freaked out. I wonder how you freaked out, if you were like screaming or if you're like squealing or making random noises. But you promised that you were going to buy us some burgers, so I'm going to hold you up to that promise. If we go, I'm expecting a bunch of burgers. But thank you and good luck. Good luck on your midterm. Is that right? Yeah, good luck. Okay, this next message is from Cho Eun-bin from Korea. Hello, DJ James, please tell me. My name is Yoo Kyung. I work in a company and I'm tired so much these days, but I get energy listening to my favorite music on James's radio. My number one musician's Royal Pirates, I love you. Please tell me, Yoo Kyung, energy up. Thank you. Well, Yoo Kyung, I can 힘내, 화이팅. Good luck to you. Thank you so much for listening, and man, I'm glad that our fans are tuning in, because we love hearing from you guys. Okay. Up next is Herlin Chua from Malaysia, who says, Hello, James. Hello, MA family. I'm so free today. How's your day going? I will be getting my exam results tomorrow, and I'm kind of worried about that because all the units in the final exam are really difficult for me. But I still hope that I can get a great result, though. Good luck for me. Well, at least you're thinking positive. That's the very least. But the best thing that can happen is you just pass with flying colors. And I know how stressful that can be because, man, I remember pulling all-nighters, and I don't recommend doing that too often. But I think there was an entire week where I just didn't sleep because I was studying too much. But yeah, don't get too focused in on that. You gotta learn how to live a little, okay? Our next message is from Den Carmel Solis from the Philippines. James Oppa, I'm so happy out loud. I don't know if that means to scream it out loud or if she. Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay, I'm happy out loud. You just made my day when you started talking. What can we do with that convincing voice? Saranghae oppa, heart emoticon, and then there's a hashtag that says, please, I'm burning. I don't know. Somebody put her out, like, stop burning. You, and I don't know why you would hashtag that if you're burning. But I'm glad that you said that out loud because I know that saying things out loud is a really good exercise, and it brings life to the truth, the things that you're saying. So I'm glad that you're happy, and I will try to not be overly convincing, I guess. Next up is Carlo Dizer from or Dizer from the Philippines, and they say, "Hi, shout out from the Philippines. First time listener here. And it's so good to hear that James will be hosting today's broadcast. Fighting to you and Royal Pirates, more power." Dang, that's a powerful message. Thank you, Carlo. And I'm glad that on your first time I'm able to be here, because this is my third time. So hopefully you keep on listening and you become a regular of this show and we hear more from you. Okay. Thank you so much for everyone for sending in your messages to Message Time. Let's listen to song before we come back with Who Am I Part 2. This next is Karina with Slow Motion. I want to know you, and it's strange, we might be meeting for the first time. I don't know how much I want to know, but there's only one reason, it's your family. So let everyone who's curious know more about you. Introducing our Music Access family members, Who Am I? Who Am I Part 2? I'm sure a lot of our MA family members will be really happy to hear that this corner has made a comeback. And it's a corner to find out more about our Music Access family members, and of course, it'll help me find out more about you guys. So that's why we've brought back this corner. And all you need to do is send me messages telling me about yourselves. Your name, your age, what you do, your nickname, your family relations, what you like, what you hate, and anything. What you're into these days. So you can tell me about you just like you're talking about to your friend. And don't forget to write, Who Am I, on the title when you send your messages to our message board. And if you want to send me your messages for Who Am I Part 2, all you need to do is write Who Am I on your title and send it to me on our message board at www.arirangradio.com/music access or through your smartphone application. All right, let's listen to our first Who Am I Part 2. This is from Vivi from Brazil. Hi, James. My name is Vivian, but everyone calls me Vivi. I'm 21 years old and a Royal Pirates fan, and I'm glad you're having this experience at Music Access. I always listen to Suyun at K-Poppin', and it's really fun to hear your voices. I really love video games, and my favorite video games are Pokemon and Harvest Moon. Well, what are your favorite games? I also really love to learn new languages, and currently I'm learning Korean, so I guess we're kind of class buddies. And I hope you can get fluent in Korean really soon. I will also work hard. Well, first of all, thank you for sending in the message, Vivi. I hope you're comfortable with me calling you that. But it's good to hear that you're listening to Suyun and K-Poppin, because we're taking over Arirang, man. That's two-thirds of the band right now, but I listen to K-Poppin too every once in a while, and I think Suyun's voice is pretty charismatic, isn't it? Because I like Suyun's advice because it's very unexpected but very practical. And also, some of my favorite games, I think I played Pokemon a lot when I was in elementary school, but not recently. Recently, I've been stuck on this Spider-Man game. I'm obsessed with Spider-Man. I wear this mask like way too often. I was on tour in China, and it was Halloween, and I was just wearing the Spider-Man mask alone in my hotel room, and that's probably the saddest thing I've ever said about myself on live radio. But anyway, thank you for sending the messages. I'm gonna work really hard in Korean too, and let's have a race to see who's most fluent quickest. Okay, thanks, Vivi, and I hope you keep listening to Music Access and send us lots of messages. We're gonna listen to another song before we come back to our second Who Am I message. And this is John Mayer's Who Says. You just heard was Who Says by the extremely talented John Mayer. Hey guys, you're listening to Music Access with me, James from Royal Pirates. And it's time for our MA family to express everything about themselves with Who Am I Part 2. We have messages coming in on our message board right now, and let's listen to a couple more. This message is from Kate Krizel from the Philippines. She says, "Hi James, my name is Kate Krizel and my friends call me Kazel. I am studying in a prestigious university here in the Philippines and I'm taking up a bachelor's in sociology. I love to read novels and I'm a huge fan of Korean dramas and K-pop as well. I've been watching K-pop concerts in and out of the country and I've been to Korea and I visited Arirang during my stay in Korea. I hope Royal Pirates can visit the Philippines soon. I love your music. Please continue to create awesome songs. Love you, James." Kazel, I'm gonna call you Kazel, and I guess if I call you Kazel, you can call me Jamble because my name is James Lee, and it's pretty much the same thing. Jamble. So, hello, Kazel. This is Jamble, and congratulations, first of all, for getting into a prestigious university. That's got to be kind of difficult. And you said that you wanted us to visit the Philippines soon. Well, we really, really want to go. Like I've said this a few times before, but one of the reasons we're in the band, we made the band and we joined together is because we love to travel and we want to keep expanding our culture and our knowledge and just experiences globally. We don't want to be too limited. We want to expand. And so thank you for thinking that we create awesome songs. We'll do our best to keep doing more. Well, I hope you keep listening and send more messages to us. And for all of you who had your messages read during Who Am I, if I see your name on the message board, I'll try to remember to give you a shout out. And if you want to send me your messages for Who Am I Part 2, all you need to do is write Who Am I on your title and send it to me on our message board at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess or through your smartphone application. All right. We'll come back right after another song for All About Music Quiz. Okay, this was requested by Ruby from Malaysia. It's Carrie Underwood's Something's in the Water. All About Music and All About Quizzes. a great collaboration of music and quizzes. All About Music Quiz. A quiz that progresses receives praise, but a quiz that's always the same gets ignored. All About Music Quiz is, to say the least, the most progressive quiz you'll ever come across. Five different music quizzes from Monday through Friday. Get ready for the great music and have fun answering the quizzes. We even have a special prize for one lucky listener who sends in the correct answer. This time, our AA Music Quiz present is Janelle Monáe's album, The Arkanoid, provided to us by Warner Music. So, for our first AA Music Quiz, the format for today is guessing the person. Okay. I'm going to tell you the title of three songs, and the songs have one thing in common, it's the person. And you just need to guess who that person is. So here are the song titles. Can we get some reverb? Number one. Song title number one is Heartbreaker, and this was his first solo debut song. Number two, High High. This song was a collaboration with Top, another member from this person's group. And number three is Good Boy. This person sang this song with Taeyang. Did you get that? I hope the reverb helped you guys out. But don't worry if you didn't hear it, though, because it might be a little hard if you aren't really too familiar with K-pop. But we still have a second hint coming up. And if you know the answer, just write answer on the title and send me your message. Okay. We'll listen to a song and come back with the second hint for AA Music Quiz. Up next, we've got 너네 누나 소개시켜줘 by New East. This was requested from Mayra from Mexico. 친구야. I wanna 너네 누나. The song you just heard was 너네 누나 소개시켜줘 by New East. A collaboration between music and quizzes, All About Music Quiz. So today's AA Music Quiz format had to do with guessing the person. But this time, we're going to let you guys listen to a part of this person's song. But this song isn't included in the person's album, okay? It was actually on a very popular variety show. But I think you guys will be able to guess who it is just by listening to this person's voice. So here's the second hint, okay? Ready? Start. I think I like this song just as much as his other songs, actually. Maybe a little more. It's so good. So hooky. So you got it? If you know what the answer is, then just write answer on the title when you send in your messages on our message board. And if you think you know the answer, come to the Music Access message board at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave us your answer with the title answer. Our AA Music Quiz prize is Janelle Monáe's album, The Arkanoid, provided to us by Warner Music. Okay, before we move on, let's listen to another song. This is Royal Pirates, Seol Chonnom, requested by Madison from the USA. The song you just heard was Seol Chonnom by my band, Royal Pirates. And you're listening to Music Access with me, James from the Royal Pirates. And it's time to listen to more stories with Message Time. So Tezneem El Alami from the USA says, oh my god, I love this radio show. I absolutely love the Royal Pirates. Please give a shout out to Tezneem. Okay, shout out to Tezneem. I don't know if I did the shout. I've never really done a shout out, so... Even though our debut song was called Shout Out. Anyway, the next one is from Angie Rosas from Peru. She says, hi, could you say hello for Peru? Well, hello, Peru. Okay, next is Danielle from Australia. James, I finished school for the year and I even got an award for my arts. I'm so happy. Congratulations. Next is Nathan from Malaysia. James, do you know you have a charismatic voice too? So what do your members comment on your DJ debut? My members say stop being a robot, but they don't really care that much, so whatever. Next is Nathan from Oh, it's two messages from Nathan. Well, hello James, what did you do when you're bored and what should you do? Who did you spend most of your childhood time with? Childhood time was my sisters, and when I'm bored, I pretty much just work out. That's all I do. I work out and I write music. I need to find some more hobbies. Okay. Next is from Kim Chia from Korea. Hello, James. I'm Chia from Seoul, and I'm a huge fan of Royal Pirates. I was so excited to hear the news that you're hosting a radio show. So glad to hear your voice every day, and I always wait for the time for your time on the radio. You're an awesome DJ and can't wait for the concert either. I already bought the ticket. You already bought the ticket? What time is it right now? Oh, there it is too. Okay, it just came out then. Well, thank you. I can't wait to see you at the show. If you didn't know, we're playing a show. I'm coming up pretty soon. I'll talk about that later on. But yes, we are playing a show, and I'm glad to see that you bought that ticket. We'll see you there, Kimchi. Next is Shelly from Indonesia. And she says, Hi, James. Shelly from Indonesia here. I just want to wish that you have a good time with your radio show and fighting. Always to you and also to the listeners. And I want to tell you that I really want to come to Royal Pirates' thank you party, but I can't. What? I'm forever wishing that you and your band will come to Indonesia someday. I'm waiting. Ha 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 ha. Wow. I feel so bad because I hate waiting for things. But yeah, I wish you were there too. The thank you party is going to be a great time. And if you don't know about that, it's going to be a lot of fun. So if I was you, I would just keep looking around for thank you party and Royal Pirates. Something good's going to be coming up. Well, anyway, thanks to everyone who sent in your messages for message time. Let's listen to a song before we come back with more. This next song was requested by Hetreda from Indonesia, and it's Sheep Sense Stoker.
아마도 내일도 나는 왜 이런 사람 이런 모습이고 이런 사랑을 하고 나는 아무것도 될수 없고 바라만 보는데도 내가 그렇게 불편하니까 내가 나쁜
The song you just heard was Toka by Sheepsynch. And you're listening to Music Access with me, James of Royal Pirates. And it's almost time to wrap up the first hour. No, I don't want to go. But guess what? In the second hour, we're going to be joined by Kihun for Why So Serious. So don't go away. We'll be right back with this song, Dido, with White Flag, requested by Nelly of Mexico. One more treat for you guys. It's one more track to actually really close this segment. This is Eric Benet with Harriet Jones.
Music Access.
Welcome, welcome, welcome back to the second hour of the Thursday edition of Music Access. I'm James of Royal Pirates, the lucky guy that has been able to spend this time with all of you here on Music Access starting on Tuesday. In the second hour today, we have our Thursday corner, Why So Serious with Kihun. And I'll be right back with Kihun in just a bit. Here's how you can listen and participate. You can listen to us by visiting our website at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave your messages there on our message board. And you can also see our broadcast in real time. And another way you can tune in is through terrestrial DMB, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo, and 101.9 for Taejeong. All right, after a song, we'll come back with Why So Serious. This was a request by Yuki from Japan, 대국 남아서 리라고. If something worrisome is giving you a headache, well, what about some empathy and advice instead of a painkiller?
If you're having trouble choosing between two choices, I'll help you make the right choice if you want me to.
Don't worry any longer. Don't put off your choices any longer.
Here are two guys waiting to hear your worries and give you advice on
Why So Serious? I'll wear a mask for you. If you want a partner team. Well, hello, Kihun.
Hello, James.
처음 뵙겠습니다.
아, 처음 뵙겠습니다. Yes.
It's nice to
meet you. Yeah. Thank you.
Wow. I don't know if you guys know this, but you guys got to look at the radio. Kihun is a really, really tall guy. He's sitting down right now.
You're taller than me.
You can't really tell, but he's very tall.
Come on. He's lying. You're taller than me.
I was so into. I was like, this guy is a giant. But I'm.
You're bigger than me.
Am I?
Yeah. I'm only 180.
I didn't know until right now.
I'm only 184.
I'm 190. Yeah.
Sorry, guys. I'm a short model. I told you the moment I came here. The first time I came here, I said I'm a short model.
You're not a short model. It's all a state of mind. And you know what? Actually, I did not realize that I was this tall until right now, until I met you.
You're very tall.
Well, I got to slouch a little more then. Yeah. Well, yeah. Well, anyway. It's my first time meeting Kihun, and he seems like a very nice guy.
So do you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. And the first time we have a guy guest here in the studio. So
He seems a little disappointed, like, honestly. His facial expression.
Well, not super disappointed, but...
Slightly.
You've got
just
good
a sense.
I'm just kidding. No. He's a great guy. And I'm really glad to see you. You're good looking, as they've been telling me. You're a good looking guy.
Is that from the bottom of your heart or from the script?
It's from the script, but it's not from the bottom of my heart, but it's somewhere in there.
Somewhere in between.
He's a good looking guy. I can see.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. If a guy tells me I'm good looking, that means I'm good looking.
Is that right?
Is that right?
Okay.
Okay. Anyway, sorry, guys.
Well, do you get that a lot, though? Do a lot of people come up to you and say, man, you're so good looking and so tall? Like, you're 184 centimeters, but you look like you're like 7 feet tall. Do they say that?
Out of 10 people I meet, probably around 3.
Oh, man. The other 7 are just shy.
Am I being too humble?
Well, 3, that's more than 2, I'll tell you that much. And the other people...
Better than 1.
Yeah, and they're hiding. They're not telling you. But does it affect you, like, when they tell you that? Because not a lot of people actually hear that from strangers, you know?
Yeah, but...
Does it make you feel...
Does it make me feel good?
Yeah.
Like a Superman?
Yeah.
To be honest, I do feel good because every human would if someone compliments you for the first time.
Of course.
But from the bottom of my heart, I thank my parents.
Oh, I see.
Yes,
I see.
Like, genuinely, because I wouldn't be here without my parents and I wouldn't have the looks, or the height, whatever, wasn't for my dad and mom. So,
okay.
What I love you, dad and mom. I'm being very honest.
The guy
very
for
honest.
You, ladies. This is the guy for you. Kihun. He's a 90년생 and he's waiting for you. Okay,
sweet talker.
Well, we're pretty similar in age, right?
Yes, we are.
And we've got something kind of in common, I guess.
Kind of?
Even though I'm a singer, I occasionally model.
Only occasionally?
Yeah, just...
Are you sure?
Every once in a while, but...
No, because you have the model face.
This is getting weird. This is, we're just complimenting each other. I don't know if I'm going to follow this script because
it's on the script.
But anyway, I heard that you even won a modeling contest. Is that right?
Yes, I did. Okay. 2 years ago, 2012, it was SBS Supermodel Contest.
Oh.
So it's a contest only for models, obviously. Oh. But the show, the contest, it's been going on for 23 years.
Wow.
So it's got a long history.
Uh-huh.
And it's, you know, pulled out some great stars. Only girls, but.
I see.
Do you know Han Ye-sul?
Oh, Han Ye-sul was on that show. She was on that show?
Yeah.
Wow.
Like, she competed about 10 years ago.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
That
so she's that old. She's an actual. Oh, she is a bit old.
Oh.
But, yeah. She first debuted it through that contest. So.
Wow. So what you're trying to tell me is you're going to be the next Han Ye-sul.
The guy version. Yes.
Mr. Han Ye-sul is hopefully in the building. Guys. Welcome.
Hopefully.
No, but that's pretty awesome, though. You won the same contest as the superstars, pretty much.
Yes, in a way, yes.
So what kind of challenges and stuff did you guys have to do?
Challenges?
Was it difficult?
It is, because the contest goes for, if you get picked for the last 24 members, out of, I don't know, about 3,000 people tried out. And only 24 make it to the last round.
Okay.
The actual contest. Uh-huh. And we practice for about 4 months.
4 months?
Yeah. So
of just modeling.
You rock up in the morning, you exercise, do posing, walking practice, more exercise.
And for those of you that don't know, modeling takes discipline, actually.
It does.
Yeah, you got to know certain things about yourself that you probably wouldn't pay attention to.
Exactly.
Yeah, but, well, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
I'm two years late, but that's good to hear. I'm glad that I've made a friend who's going to be huge, the next Mr. Han Ye-sul. Well, anyway, do we have any other similarities? Like, do you like sports or anything?
Of course I do. I used to play soccer when I was young.
Soccer.
Football, they say, as they say it.
Soccer.
What about you? Do you like?
I played water polo when I was in college and high school.
Water polo.
Are you familiar with water polo?
I know what it is, but
it's like soccer.
I'm not a good
swimmer,
so.
Oh, really?
I don't like water.
Oh,
I'm
man.
Not a big fan of
water. The world is like 70% water, man.
I don't like being on land.
Well, you know what? Soccer, I think it's one of the most popular sports
in
the world. And I only played it twice in my life. Yeah.
Twice?
But my first time ever playing, I got a hat trick.
You got a hat trick?
Hat trick, my first time.
You must be a gifted sportsman.
I was born, but then it wasn't real soccer. I was wearing a bubble suit, and you just like
bump
into each other. Yeah, so I was just fouling the entire time.
Like luxury kind of sports.
Is that a luxury sport?
Not many people can do it.
You just knock people on their
butt.
Wow. Well, all right. Well, where do you live right now? Like, where are you?
Where do staying? I live? Do I have to say this
are you
on
in,
air?
You're living in Korea?
Yes, I am. I'm living in Korea.
Oh, okay. Because your accent is not Korean. It's very... Are
slightly
you from
Aussie.
Australia. It's from Australia.
Yes, Australia.
Because okay. Every time I try to do an Australian accent, it turned into some kind of gangster, like, person with a just... Yeah,
you know what? You should learn from Aaron.
Aaron?
He copies me a lot.
Is he good?
He's all right. He's all right.
I always get criticized for my accents that they're just terrible.
Yeah. What? When
I try to imitate.
Oh.
Yeah. Maybe you can teach me a little bit.
Maybe.
Yeah. Okay. Well, you've lived in... Oh, okay. So you've lived in Australia apparently a long time before coming to Korea.
Yes.
So what do you do here for fun? Like, is there any time that you get stressed here in Korea?
Every day.
Every day?
I'm joking. Not every day. Every now and then, if I do get stressed, I tend to just go out, meet friends, just don't think about anything, and just chill out.
Just try to empty your mind.
Yeah, just be with people that I like and that I'm comfortable with.
That give you, like, positive energy.
Yeah. And I just go out, meet people.
Do you hang out with the models that you beat and you just feel good because you beat them all?
honestly, yeah, sometimes.
That's terrible. I'm just kidding.
No.
I did not mean to facilitate.
Like, I just hang around a lot of friends that I like personally, not just through like socially or just like through work.
Yeah,
but just people that I really like, genuinely.
So you met them before your work?
Yeah.
Or
they're not models. They're just
they're regular.
They're all over the place.
Oh, okay.
They do, you know, whatever, different jobs.
All right. Well, you know what? I'm feeling pretty comfortable right now.
I feel
like I just got like a friend in the
Me
studio.
Too.
I was intimidated by your height, but now I realize I'm more intimidating. I didn't know that, but you know what? I've got a friend in the studio. Why don't we listen to a song before we come back?
Yeah.
And we listen to some of the worries and the concerns that our Music Access family members actually have. Up next, we've got A-Pink's Love.
Lev.
Levy. The song you just heard was Love by A-Pink, and that's spelled L-U-V, not L-O-V-E. You're listening to
Lev.
James.
Lev.
James from Royal Pirates and Kuhn on Why So Serious, where we discuss the concerns and worries of our Music Access family members. And so, Kuhn, can you tell us about The Corner and how our listeners can participate?
Sure. Why So Serious is all about sharing your worries and concerns and thinking together about possible solutions or even some advice. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's really comforting to just have someone listen to your worries, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Yes. That's what this corner is all about. I hope you guys can open up to us and let us know what's worrying you. So mm-hmm. the first part is, should I choose A or B? That is the question.
Okay.
If there's anyone that's worried about choosing A or B, we'll help you out based on our own experience.
All right.
So here's our first message.
Nice.
All right, we've got Yuki from Japan.
Nice.
Hi, Kuhn and James. I'm worried about my part-time job. Mm-hmm. Would you answer my problem and give me some advice? I have two part-time jobs. One is a very, very
so many varies.
Very hard, and I feel depressed. But it's three times good payment than the other job.
Wow.
The other is not so busy and I can enjoy the work, but not good pay. Though I'm going to quit one of them, I can't decide which one to quit. If you and me, which do you choose, Kuhn and James?
Okay. You want me to respond first? I think I'm going to have to respond first, because when I was in college, I actually worked three jobs at the same time.
Three?
Like, yeah, I was
living... You're a three-timer.
Yeah, when I was...
no, three, yes.
And it's, I know exactly how stressful that can be. Like, you wake up and you don't know, like, what... You're always in a state of panic. And, oh, man, I remember... Because when I was in college, I lived I lived kind of far from home. So I was sleeping in my car.
Wow.
I was sleeping in my car, just trying to, just working odd jobs here and there.
Just to survive and pay your
to pay for just gas and just everything else that I need, like books. But so I would want to know for Yuki if, first of all, is she in a position where she has responsibilities, where she has to pay for a certain thing? For example, your rent, or are you going to be missing out on a meal? Are you going to skip meals because you don't have money? If it's desperate like that, then obviously you got to suck it up. And even though you're depressed, you got to do the harder job because it pays better. But if you're feeling so stressed, you're not going to, it's going to, stress is a big killer, man. It can tear you apart. So I guess I would say if you're in a period of desperation where you need the finances, keep that job and keep the relationship with the other job going okay. Like, let them know that you just, this is not the time for you to have that other job. But if finances aren't a huge issue right now, take a step back and go to the fun job, because you want to enjoy yourself. You want to live a happy life. Okay, Mr. Australia.
No, you just answered my...
I'm sorry.
Wow. Everyone, James, he's a very smart man.
Am I?
He knows how to talk. He knows how to talk and give good advices.
Then when I speak Korean, how come nobody listens?
See, no one's perfect. You know, God's very fair.
Why is
he
so
fair? You can't have everything.
I wish
like,
he was...
Like what you said, you know, if money's a problem, suck it up and just, you know, hang in there and go for the job that gives you good payment.
Uh-huh.
But if money's not that big of an issue... I think, I mean, you know, if you're getting stressed too much, it's not going to help out at all, your health. And if you're thinking about a long-time job, I think, yeah, just going for the part-time job that gives you less payment but more enjoyment, go for that.
All right.
Because money's not everything.
Yeah, man.
And I think you're a young girl, Yuki. Well, I don't know how old you are exactly, but I mean, at a young age, unless you have many responsibilities, which we don't know personally, but at a young age, like even our age, money is a big issue, but you know, once we grow up, money will become a bigger issue. So just enjoy what you can enjoy right now.
Yeah.
That's my advice.
All right, man. That's some fantastic advice. Thank you so much.
I tried, but he's too good.
No, he's too good.
He's textbook answers.
He's building up the expectations, and that's not good.
I gotta study harder.
All right, let me get to the next question.
Okay.
This is from Kim Hyemin from Korea. Hi, James and Kyun. I'm Hyemin from Cheonan. Here is my why so serious story. So, my mother is planning to do kimjang this weekend, which is making kimchi in the winter. And in Korea, it's quite a big event, so she wants me to come home and help her. But I have someone who I really want to meet this weekend. Maybe it's going to be the last time that I can see him.
Oh, he's going to the army.
Is that right?
Is he? Boyfriend? No?
I'm not good at making kimchi, so I don't think that I can help her a lot. Also, there are two more people in my family who can already help her. Should I go to my hometown and do kimjang, or just meet the one that I like? Give me some advice. All right, Mr. Australia, what's your answer?
Hyemin, are you listening, Hyemin? Is it love or family?
Oh,
that's the question.
Yeah.
Honestly, I don't know how old you are, but yes, it's a very busy season where all Korean moms, you know, start making kimchi.
Uh-huh.
It's called kimjang, kimjang season. I totally understand because my mom's doing the same thing. But with me, I would actually help my mom out because I'm a very family-oriented person.
What a sweet...
Even though I don't look like it.
Oh, yeah.
I look like a rebel, like, you know, going for girls. But I love my family. I think family comes first for me. But, Hyemin, are you listening? If you love this guy and if it's your last chance of meeting him, I don't know why. Maybe he's going to the army. Yeah, just go meet him. Go meet him, you know?
Okay, all right.
Love is important. You just heard that song by A-Pink, Love.
So you pick meeting the guy.
Yeah, meet the guy.
Meet the guy.
If it's your last chance of meeting him, meet the guy.
So ladies and gentlemen, you heard
Kim
it.
Jong will come the next year
you
and the year after. We'll keep coming every year.
You heard it from Mr. Kyun, who says, Mr. Australia says, leave your families.
No, because she mentioned she has two more siblings.
That's true.
Who can help out. So,
well, you know what? I think that he's giving very practical advice.
Very practical.
I think it's kind of our natural instinct. And to be honest, this is what I feel. You've already justified in your head why you think that you should meet this guy. You like this
guy.
You
answered your own question.
You're like, my mom wants me, but she already has, like, so many other people to help her. And I love this guy, kind of. But, yeah, she has so much help on the side. No, you already made up your mind you really want to meet this guy.
Is it Kimjang or Namja? It's Namja.
So, well, I guess what I'd say is, personally, I'm kind of a mama's boy, you know?
And really?
I haven't seen my family in a long time. Oh, so I would...
Mama boy.
Yeah, personally, I would pick my mom over a girl, I think. Because
they're both girls, but
yeah, I know, but over like a love interest, but that's because I haven't felt that like that spark in a long time, you know. So maybe that's what she has.
Do they do kimjang in the States?
No, we've never done kimjang.
You just buy kimchi,
yeah.
Oh, so it's a different...
And
you
actually,
wouldn't know how it that kind of season,
yeah.
All the Korean moms start, you know,
but instead of kimjang, I eat burritos because I really like burritos. But
a Korean guy saying, I like burritos.
So you like
burritos over kimchi?
If it was kimjang with my mom or going to eat burritos, I think I would just melt down. I don't know what I would do. But
Americans.
So what I want to say to you is, Hyemin, Kim Hyemin Shi, Hyemina, I don't know how to address you.
Hyemin from Cheonan.
It's important to stay loyal to your family, but if you've got this spark thing, if you get, I guess, your parents' permission, I think it's good to go meet this guy. But
yeah, because family will always stay for you forever.
Yeah.
But with this guy, you know, yeah. they might he might leave you.
There's plenty of fish in the sea. There's so many other options. So
hey, I love that phrase. Right?
Phrase. Yeah, it's
there are plenty of fish.
Don't stress out over this guy. Like, family relationship is most important. But if you get her hodok, if you get her permission, then go for it, because you know your family says okay, it's what you want to do. Mm. Do what you want to do.
He could be waiting for you at Cheonan or in Seoul.
All right, next, can you introduce the next
okay,
one?
Okay, we have Nelly Perez from Mexico.
Okay, hello, Nelly.
Hello, Mr. Australia and Mr. James. Oh. I'm finally going on a second date with a person I've had a crush on for a long time.
Wow.
I'm debating if I should bake some brownies or chocolate chip cookies to take on the second date. Wow. That is so sweet.
Oh, man.
But I heard that guys don't like sweet stuff. Well, at least Aaron says he doesn't like sweets.
What?
Well, that's just Aaron. He's weird. Oh, he's not weird. He's different. What do you guys think? Should I go ahead and bake something for the guy, whether he likes it or not? Or should I wait until I find out what he really likes? What should I do?
Mr. Australia, what is your choice?
If I had a girlfriend who cooks something by herself and brings it out for our date, I would be... Oh, I would just melt down.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, I would love her.
Is Nelly Perez meeting you? Or is it just... It's just...
Hypothetically speaking,
okay,
yes.
Okay.
I can't meet someone from Mexico. But, I mean, if you have that kind of affection and mind to do that, make something for your boyfriend, that is... Go for it. Because, I don't know, most guys would love that, like that. You know? They'll be touched.
I think... Okay. So...
That's my... Go for it.
That's a
bake a lot of cookies and send some to Arirang. Yeah, I want to try it as well.
So I think something that all guys have in common are that they like receiving gifts, right?
Everyone,
right?
Everyone
likes that. But I gotta say, like, I don't know why Aaron doesn't like sweets, but I love sweets personally. Mm. I'm obsessed with them, and I've had several trips to the dentist because of this issue. But
have you ever received like presents from girls where they actually, you know, bake something or make something for you at home, like lollies or cookies, whatever?
It's been such a long time. Well, our fans sometimes give us like cookies and stuff, and it means so much.
Fans.
Yeah, it's kind of it really brings your spirits up. Mm-hmm. But I gotta say, the second date, all right. So, depending on where you're from, do you know what this concept of mirtang is? Mirtang?
Yeah.
I didn't know about it until
push
Korea.
And pull, push and pull.
It's like, what do you want? Like, why are you playing with
it's
my emotions?
It's something Koreans do a lot.
All right.
They enjoy doing. Yeah. Only Koreans.
But apparently, some girls like it when you tell them you don't like them.
But you actually do. Deep inside.
So, I don't know. I'm not the best person to ask for relationship advice. So, you know what? Let's just go with Kyun. Kyun says, make the brownies, make the cookies.
Because this is my theory in life.
Uh-huh.
Give and take.
Okay.
You give first and you take some later. You know?
So you're investing in the stock of this guy with cookies.
Future investment.
You're receiving a lifetime of just love.
Because if you give, you know, give brownies to the guy, next time on your third date, you never know what he's going to do for you.
Mm-hmm.
He might buy you a present, like bigger present.
Okay.
Depending, I don't know, depending on the guy. But if you want to do it, just do it.
Comparing guys to stocks, it's not, I guess, some guys are simple-minded. I'm pretty simple-minded.
Most guys are very simple-minded.
All righty, well, you heard it here. Make him the brownies and make him the cookies.
No, because I reckon it's, you know... It's not you're not buying him something that's really expensive.
Yeah.
It's just your thoughts and feelings.
Yeah, and don't you know what? I think that's actually a good idea. Bring the brownies and cookies, but don't make a big show out of it. Don't be like
ta-da.
Yeah, like just be like, oh, I made some brownies and cookies for you. And then he'll be like, oh wow, she's sweet.
Yeah.
Rather than if you're like, oh, I slaved away for these brownies and cookies, then he's gonna be like,
you know how many hours I put in.
You're really weird. Like, yeah. You gotta control.
Just be cool
that,
with it.
Yeah, yeah.
That's called mirtang.
Oh,
push and pull. You know, playing with the guy's mind.
You dance very well.
Oh, do I? Oh, sorry.
Compared to
I'm a
me.
Little. Oh. Keep calm.
All righty. Okay. Let's get to the next message.
Yep.
This is from Lordy's from Mexico, and they said, oh my god, we have a big problem at home among our family members. I don't know if I need to get involved and try to help our family members solve the problem, or should I stand back a little bit and wait before taking the first step? P.S. How are family problems solved? Okay, so it's either get involved and try to help solve the problem, or B, stand back and let them figure it out. What would you do, Mr. Australia?
I think it would depend on the problem. Mm-hmm. I don't know. When you say big problem, mm-hmm. I don't know how big it is, but...
Let's say it's really big. It's like a disaster.
Really big?
Yeah.
I'll take a step back first, mm-hmm. and just let them play, let them, you know, try to solve it. But if it really doesn't work, then that's when I would step in and just mm-hmm. do something about it.
Okay, so you'd kind of do mirtang with your family.
Oh yeah, in a way, in a way. You know, first I'd be like, nah, and then, you know.
Is that life? Do we just figure out life right now?
That's life.
Well, you know what?
What about you?
I think, personally, I'm a very emotional person, so I would say the smart thing to do, this is what Suyun would say, because he's a smart guy, he's smarter than I am, I'll tell you that much, but he would step back, he would let them figure it out.
At first.
And he would let them, because a lot of the times when emotions get involved, you end up adding fuel to the flame, and yes. The problem just grows.
It doesn't end up in a good result.
Yeah, and so... Basically, I would just be there to facilitate the communication. I would be like...
The mediator.
You're not actually listening, and you are not actually listening. You guys are talking at each other and not to each other. So that's what I would do. And that's what I would say.
You seem like a lawyer.
No, I'm not a lawyer. Lawyer. I'm the farthest thing.
He's got that lawyer image as well. Very smart, direct.
Let me tell you this.
Educated.
No. The problem is...
Anyway, yeah.
The problem is I'm too emotional, and what always happens whenever there's a fight... We just start yelling. Everyone starts yelling. And
do you cry a lot for a guy?
Not for you know what? Moon and Suyun say I cry a lot.
Because I'm very.
We're just.
I don't look
criers.
Like it, but
I'm very embarrassed of myself.
Very soft. Right now. Very soft, like a soft cookie, you know.
When I just saw you're like a soft cookie.
like a brownie, chocolate brownie. I melt down, you know. No, because I'm very emotional as well. And when it comes to family issues, I become very serious and considerate. Because, you know, if it's friends issues, you can just solve it. Mm-hmm. Either just ignore it or just step in and take action. Mm-hmm. But with family, I mean, there's someone you're going to see for the rest of your lives. And there's only one in your life. So... I'll be pretty serious.
Yeah. So what I think you should do is first step back like Kyun said, because that's probably the smarter thing to do. What I would do is get in there and mess everything up, because that's just my personality. And you know what? Just remember this. When you're arguing, when you guys are communicating, when you yell, that's the lowest form of communication, right? You got to not yell. You got to reason and be rational, but remember that you guys are always going to be there for each other.
Hallelujah. Okay? Hallelujah. Amen.
Okay, yes. So a lot of our listeners were thinking, should I choose A or B? That is the question. We try to help them make a choice. And please remember, the final choice is up to you, because we don't want that pudam. But we hope that we were able to be some help to you guys, okay? So let's listen to a song before we move on. Nurul from Malaysia requested Beats 12시 30분. Alright, the song you just heard was 12시 30분 by Beast. Okay, you're listening to our new Thursday Corner, Why So Serious, with Kihun. And we just got some messages, some shout-outs. Can you read those for us?
Yes, we have Liana from Malaysia.
Okay.
You guys can be best friends, James and Kihun. Jog together, maybe? Don't let James play alone.
Do I seem lonely?
I'm just kidding. I never knew. He has no friends? Okay, I'll be a friend. I'll be a friend.
Thanks, buddy.
I'm joking.
I feel sad about myself.
Do you want to read the next one?
Alrighty, okay. Carolina Miki Sugimoto from Brazil says, I'll make cookies for you guys. I would bake lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of cookies for you guys, but you have to come and get it in Brazil.
No thanks.
Those are expensive cookies. That's a 30-hour flight, isn't it?
Just to eat your cookies? I'll think about it in the future.
They better be super delicious. I'm waiting for this. Okay. Well, moving on. This time, we're going to put our heads together to give our listeners some good advice they can follow. So let's listen to the first message for this segment. Can you read that for us?
Okay, we have Sidika from Turkey. Mm-hmm. Hello, James and Kihoon. This is my first year in university. I'll graduate...
Last year.
Oh, sorry, no, guys. Noise. I'm sorry. This is my last year in university. I'll graduate psychology department, but I'm worried about my future because I still can't decide what to do. I think student life is easier than working life. What do you think? Do you guys ever worry about what to do in the future? Do you ever worry about the decision you made? Did you have any regrets about your decisions? I wonder if MA family members are worried like I am and what they dream about. I have a lot of questions today, don't I? No, you don't. It's only three. I'm joking.
No, but you're right. Sudika has a lot on their mind, and I think everyone thinks about these points like at one point or another in their life. So when did you ever worry like this, Kyun? Did you ever worry about...
When I decided to come to Korea, I was attending my first year of university, and it wasn't a bad course, and it was a good university, good future planned ahead, but I dropped out.
Oh, really?
By myself, voluntarily.
Wow.
Without my mum and brother knowing. Which is pretty crazy if I think of it now.
That's pretty
insane. Yeah, I was only 20 years old. Mm-hmm. You know, everyone's thinking of me, Kyun, you got to study hard. You'll become, you have a good future ahead of you. Mm-hmm. And one day, I tell my brother and mom, I'm going to Korea next week.
What? Next week?
Yeah. I booked a flight, like one-way ticket, packed my luggage, dropped out of school, got everything, sorted out. Mm-hmm. And I was like, mom, brother, I'm going to Korea.
So do you have any regrets or anything? Like,
I did regret for a moment, but now I'm happy with my life.
Oh, really?
Absolutely happy.
Okay. So I guess you'd say you followed your passion, right?
Yes. Follow your heart.
And you're happy with that.
I am.
I'm on the same boat. I didn't know any Korean when I came here. I followed my passion. And I don't know if that's the best advice for practicality, but I know that I'm going to have inner peace because eventually you regret the chances you didn't take, right? And I've seen that on like random fortune cookies and stuff, but I think it's practical advice as well.
You only live once and you live your own life. No one's going to live it for you, so go for it.
I don't know if our advice helped, but I hope that I seriously had sincere concern and thoughts for her, so good luck to her. And
good luck.
Yeah, thank you for being brave and telling us about your serious concerns and worries. It's already time for us to say goodbye.
Already?
Yeah, it's already time. But how was it?
Wow.
Is it good?
I mean, it was amazing.
Oh, man.
I know you felt a bit disappointed.
No.
At first seeing me because I was a guy, but I enjoyed it. I had fun.
He read me like a book.
I did.
But
like a book.
Anyway, no, it was amazing. I had a great time. It was great meeting you. And I hope we can meet again sometime soon. So.
Yeah, like outside.
Awesome.
Outside, awesome. Yeah.
Okay, so sending Kyun out here with this song. It's D-Sound with Sings Bye-Bye. I'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye. Just heard was D-Sound Sings. I'm James from Royal Pirates filling in for Aaron here on Music Access, and it's now time to reveal the answer for AA Music Quiz from the first hour. So what is the answer? The answer is G-Dragon, GD, and a lot of people sent us the right answer, but we had to just pick one, and so here's our lucky winner. Congratulations to Ragda Bekri from Tunisia. Ragda Bekri. We'll post it up on our message board to make sure to take a look. And if you see your name there, please send us an email at musicaccess@arirang.co.kr with your name, address, phone number, and the date you were chosen, as well as your email address. Our AA Music Quiz prize is Janelle Monae's album, The Arkanroid, provided to us by Warner Music. So thank you everybody for sending in your messages today. Next, we're going to listen to a song that was requested by our listeners. This is Pix with 다칠 준비가 돼 있어, requested by Lisa Wu from the UK. You just listened to 다칠 준비가 돼 있어 by Vix. And we are going to listen to one more message from Isabel from the Philippines. Isabel says, "Hello, James. How was your day so far? Hosting a radio show can be nerve-wracking, isn't it? But after a few days of doing this, I think you're starting to get the hang of it, and after all, experience is the best way to learn new things. Looking forward on the days to come with you as your host there, and enjoy hosting and take care, and happy Thanksgiving too! P.S. We, the Filipino fans, hope that the Royal Pirates can visit the Philippines one day. And we really, really want to go there too, and you know what? It's American Thanksgiving today. I'm not with my family right now, but I'm with you guys, and luckily I can have my American Thanksgiving in Korea with you guys on Arirang. And it's already time to say goodbye, and this, you know what? The second segment passes by too fast. I miss you guys already, but I feel like I got to get personal with you all, and just keep making sure to let us know your requests, sending in your messages, so I can get to know you and let's cultivate this relationship. Okay. Our last song for the day today is Calvin Harris's with Together featuring Gwen Stefani. I'm James Lee of Royal Pirates. Thank you so much. We'll see you next time.